Good morning, my student. Please register who is attending on lecture today. The topic of our lecture today: BIM method diagnostic of tumor of lung and the organ of mediastinum. Today, your investigation. Malignant tumor of lung and investigation, benign tumor and malignant tumor, organs of mediastinum. Benign tumor of lung, I am explaining to you before. Today, I am explaining to you, begin explaining cancer of lung. Cancer of lung. Да, пошли, я сразу перезвоню. Cancer of lungs. Cancer of lungs. Lung cancer is a malignant tumor that develops from the epithelium of the mucous membranes of bronchi, bronchial glands. This is named bronchogenic cancer or alveolar tissue, lung or pneumogenic cancer. Now I am show to you pathomorphological examination of lungs, of lungs. Guys, now I am explaining to you difference between benign tumor and malignant tumor. Main property which character for benign tumor. Benign tumor grow slowly. Benign tumor growth is slowly. Expansive growth. What is this expansive growth? When tumor shift outside, around tissue. Benign tumor do not give metastasis. But it must be remembered that some benign tumor can become malignant, transformation in malignant tumors. Malignant tumors, growth infiltratively. Growth, you see, growth infiltratively. Growth inside around tissue, growing into surround organs and give metastasis. Without treatment, malignant tumors lead to the death of the patient. several questions, statistic cancer of lungs. About 5 million people die from cancer of lung annually. In Western countries, cancer of lung annually kills 50 to 80 people per 100,000 population. One by two of deaths among men and one by five among women are from lung cancer. Despite the success of modern medicine, lethal the rate of lung cancer is 85% of the number of cases. In Russia Federation, cancer of lung ranked first among oncologic diseases. Cancer of lung is the cause of death in 32% of men and 72% women who have been found to have any malignant neoplasm. Now I am showing to you building oncology center Russian Academy Medical Science, named after Blokhina. This center localization in Moscow City, Kashir Street. Risk factors. Is very often main reasons EPR. Cancer of lung, smoking. Next, inhalation radon gas. The suspicions which drops in site underground. Asbestosis. Before I am explaining to you, asbest. If inhalation asbest is very often complication cancer of lung. Next. Not favorable environment. Air pollution is bad substance. Radiation beams. And substance which damage genetic apparat of peoples. All harmful compounds inhalate with cigarette smoke permanently settle off the lungs. They do not dissolve and don't to outside, but form clusters slowly covering the lungs with black soot. Now I am showing to you macro preparat pathomorphological investigation of lungs. These patients non-smoke. These lung patients which often not long smoked. This is lung of a long smoked person. Cancer of lungs. Next. Cancer of lungs. The cancer of lungs is the most widespread malignant formation. About 1 million of new cases of this frightening disease are annually diagnosed in the world that make up 12% from the number of all exposed malignant tumors. The cancer of lungs are the most common, 20-30% in the structure of neoplastic disease of masculine population of many countries of the world. Morbidity by the cancer of lung and death rate from the repeatedly grave on comparison with the first decades of 20th century, when it was considered as a rare disease. Сережа любит свои читать инструментом. Я как закончу перезвоню. Last year there is quick growth of malignant formation of lung and in women. Especially in the countries of the West, the doctors explain by the sharp increase among them who has smoking habits. The rhinologist method is a basic diagnostic method and especially in the early exposure of cancer of lungs. The special importance of acquired by the purposeful annual fluorography inspection of elderly person, age 40 years, and the group of the promoted risk. A. Smoked before I'm explaining to you. B. Patients coughing and secrete phlegm. And C. Chronic pulmonary disease and chronic bronchitis. Control prophylactic fluorographic research is necessary conducted 2 times per year. There are various classification of cancer of lungs. For rhinologists, there are various classification of cancer of lung. For rhinologists, most assessable those is the basic of which anatomic principle of fixed. There are that are reflected. A microscopic kind of tumors, B its localization, C character of growth. Character of growth. Next. You see, the following classification of cancer of lungs by localization, cancer of lung central and peripheral. Localization, cancer of lung central and peripheral. Direction of growth, direction of growth. First, exobronchial growth cancer. Second, endobronchial growth cancer. And peribronchial growth cancer. Growth along the wall of bronchi. Complication. Complication. One, intended with violation of ventilation of lung. Number two, disintegrating. Number three, germination of neighboring organs. Number four, pleurisy, damage visceral and parietal pleura, which accompanied cancer etiology, pleurisy, maybe exudate pleurisy. Character of metastasis, character of metastasis, without metastasis, number two, with regional metastasis, number three, with remote metastasis. Next. Now I am show to you schematic imaging of localization of lung cancer. Number one, central lung cancer. Number two, endobronchial lung cancer. Number three, peribronchial growth. Excuse me. Number one, central lung cancer, number two, endobronchial lung cancer, number three, peripheral lung cancer, peripheral localization lung cancer. Central cancer of lung. Now I am show to you and explain central cancer of lung. Central lung cancer develops from the epithelium of mucous membrane of large bronchi of 1-3 order. Main bronchus, lobular bronchus, segmental bronchus. In relation to lumen of the bronchi, endobronchial tumor growth, exobronchial growth and the growth of peribronchial cancer are distinguished. When a malignant tumor arising in the wall of bronchus spreads along the bronchi and blood vessels. Now I am show to you schematic imaging central cancer of lung. Usually, main radiological symptoms, usually pathological formation, localization, projection, root of lungs. Next, central lung cancer develops from the epithelial tissue of the segmental lobular and main bronchi, the typical site of localization of the mouth of segmental bronchi, most often the upper lobe of the lung and affected usually segmentum 3, as well as the right lung. Any localization of the tumor can be determined, depending on the nature of the development of malignant neoplasm. Central lung cancer is divided into the following types: nodular form of central lung cancer, predominantly endobronchial cancer, spreads into the lumen of the bronchus. Predominantly endobronchial cancer, when cancer grows inside lumina of the bronchus. Next, predominantly exobronchial cancer, spreads of opposite direction from the lumen of the bronchus. Next, a branched form of central lung cancer, predominantly peribronchial cancer. In central lung cancer, the X-ray picture is characterized by the changes in the root caused by the shadow of neoplasm, changes in the section of lung, which is ventilated by the affected bronchus. At the later stage of malignant process, metastatic lesions of the chest organ are determined. You see, are determined. Central lung cancer, schematic imaging, central lung cancer, schematic imaging of the X-ray pictures. You see, central lung cancer, enlargement of the root of the right. You see, due to shadow of the tumors, atelectasis, you see atelectasis of the upper lobe. Next, effusion into the pleural cavity. Effusion into the pleural cavity. You can see symptoms exudate pleurisy. In lower fields of the right side, for example, this is of the right side. You can see lower fields, mainly lateral inner zones. You can see shadow intensive homogeneity. Upper margin is oblique, indistinct, uneven. This line is named line Elisa Domoazo. In the left lung, changes of the root of lung caused by metastatic processes are determined. Radiograph show is expansion of lung root with the indistinct and uneven outline. Radiant or bumpy. The structure of root is lost. In the root zones of the lung, line shadow can be determined, which fan out from the root. ZZ shadow, R2 lymphangitis. In result, lymphangitis. Now I am show to you schematic image. Next I show to you original image. Exobronchial cancer is defined as a shadow of the root of lung with intestine radially divergent outlines. Subsequently, when the tumor metastasizes of the lymph nodes of the lung root, the shadow of cancerous tumor is determined on X-ray images, which directly attaches to the root. This tumor conglomerate take on the appearance of intense darkening with polycyclic irregular outlines. You see? Later, when moving along the bronchi and blood vessels, the tumor spreads to the surround lung tissue and further to the periphery. You see, on the rengenogram, this is rengenogram of the left lung appears as irregular streaky shadow without clearly outlines. You see? Amounting from an uneven shadow of the root area. This is shadow localization projection root of the left lung. Outlines is not well defined, and outlines spread to the lateral side. This is X-ray picture is described as a symptom the rising sun, sunrise symptoms. These symptoms is named sunrise symptoms. In the later stage of growth, there is a gradual growth of the tumor in the lumina of bronchus and a violation of bronchial passage up to development of atelectasis. This is character for later stage growth development center cancer. Now, guys, now I am show to you classic imaging center cancer, center exobronchial cancer of the left lung. Central exobronchial cancer of the left lung. Next. Central exobronchial cancer of lungs. Now I am show to you graphic imaging X-ray plane central lung cancer, tumor more than 6 plus minus 6 centimeters. On the rengenogram, in the projection of the root of the right lung, you can see an intensive shadow. Non-homogeneous, with radiant outlines diverging to the periphery with a diameter about 6 centimeters. These symptoms, sunrise symptoms. There's a sunrise symptoms. Now I will show to you next image, central cancer exobronchially growing. Central exobronchial cancer of the right lung. For central lung cancer, exobronchially growing, the presence of the root zones now of the right lung, of the shadow. You see shadow, shadow with indistinct in the form of strands radially divergent outlines. These symptoms is named sunrise symptoms. Is characteristic which emphasizes the radially divergent nature of shadow due to infiltrative growth of cancer. Now I am show to you original rentgenogram central exobronchial growth cancer. Central exobronchial growth cancer. The rentgenogram of the chest in PA projection of the projection root of the right lung, you can see shadow. You can see shadow. Shadow intensive, non-homogeneity. Outlines is indistinct, not uneven. This is sunrise symptoms. Sunrise symptoms. This is shadow localization projection root of the right lung, but spreading outside. This is character for infiltrative growth tumors. Character for infiltrative growth tumors. Conclusion, central exobronchial cancer of the right lung. Now I am showing to you computer tomography of the chest, axial projection lung tissue window. Lung tissue window. On the projection root of the right lung, you can see exobronchial cancer, which have 70 Hounsfield unit. Outlines indistinct, uneven. This is computer tomography imaging, character for central exobronchial cancer of lungs. Next. Next. Peribronchial cancer. Listen to me, it's very, very attentive. Peribronchial cancer. IPA is rare. In the case of malignant tumor, which has arisen in the form of a small node, quickly begins to spread along the bronchi and blood vessels, given in irregular ribbon shadow of the X-ray image. Fan-shaped form of the root into the lung tissue. With this form of lung cancer, when infiltrative growth predominates, the lumen of the bronchi remain possible for a long time and ventilation of the lungs and practically not disturbed. You see, this is, you can see line shadow, light shadow, which localization, projection, lumina, bronchus, around wall of bronchus, and spreading along the bronchi and blood vessels. You see line shadow, line shadow, line shadow, peribronchial cancer. Main symptoms, you can see projection root of the right lung, shadow intensive, non-homogeneity, and outside you can see line shadow, which spreading along the bronchi and blood vessels. You see? Line shadow. Now I am showing to you computer tomography imaging peribronchial cancer of lung. It's characterized by the growth of tumor along the entire course of the bronchial tree. You see? Growth around bronchus and long bronchus. There is no pronounced tumor nodes. Tumor infiltrate circularly covers the sections of the bronchial wall and spreads along its with the transition of the surrounding lung tissue. You see? Good reveals lumina bronchus, good reveals lumina bronchus, and around bronchus and long bronchus, spreads along bronchus. You can see pathological, you see, formation. You see, infiltrative tumor growth is circular along the right upper lower bronchus. This is CT scan, axial projection, lung tissue window. Next, I will show to you computer tomography, central peribronchial cancer of right lung. This is computer tomography, coronal projection, lung tissue window. Good reveals branched peribronchial growth, peribronchial growth cancer of left lungs, of the left lung. Next, I will show to you computer tomography imaging, coronal projection, lung tissue window. Also, I will show to you peribronchial central lung cancer. Peribronchial central lung cancer. You see? Lumina bronchus. And outside from wall of the bronchus, you spreading peripheral side to peripheral side shadow. And on the computer tomography of the left lung, you can see one more symptoms, decreased volume of the left lung. Next topic is very important topic, endobronchial lung cancer. Endobronchial lung cancer. Endobronchial lung cancer, I am explaining to you before, when tumor growth inside lumina of the bronchus. On the rengenogram, usually primary tumors, you don't can see. Why? Primary tumors, this is soft tissue. And main rengenological symptoms, which you can see on the rengenogram, there's a changes in lung at absent on bronchial pathway. Bronchial pathway. Types of bronchial obstruction, types of disorder bronchial obstruction. Bronchial obstruction. This is stage number one. Stage number one. This is rengenological classification. Hyperventilation, hyperventilation, hyperventilation. When tumors obstruction only part lumina of the bronchus. And pathway present, pathway present, ventilation present affected lung, but ventilation is decreased. And on the rengenogram you can see main rengenological symptoms. Hyperventilation, hyperventilation. If patients do full inspiration, full inspiration, affected lung constantly, volume is decreased. Volume is decreased. On the rengenogram you can see more higher rengenological density, more higher rengenological density. Next stage, volume emphysema. Next stage, volume emphysema. Valvular emphysema, next stage. When tumor is growth, 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 but when patients do inspiration, wall of the bronchus have elastic property, And lumina of bronchus, lumina of the bronchus increased and gas pass, air pass inside damage lung. When patients do expiration, wall of the bronchus decreased and gas no passage outside in environment. If patients do full expiration, affected lung constantly volume is increased. Constantly volume is increased. And next stage, atelectasis. When tumor, total occlusion lumina bronchus, and gas, no passage outside, gas, which localization inside affected lung resorption into blood, and volume decreased. This is information, pathological conditional atelectasis. Atelectasis affected lung. Atelectasis affected lung. Collapse of affected lung. Now I am showing to you and explain this stage. Guys, endobronchial cancer. Endobronchial cancer is first phase of the growth when a tumor has minimum size clinically, the rengenological shows up nothing. And rengenological, before I am explaining to you, Initial stage when tumors is very small on the rengenogram and clinically is clinical symptoms is absent. Second phase, but rengenologically this is first stage. Second phase of growth of characterized by the increase of cancer node and violation passing of air in the proper lung, maybe low, maybe segment, which show hyperventilation. Now, before I am explaining to you, but now I am showing to you text and explain original radiological investigation. This is rentgenogram, hyperventilation of the left lung, hyperventilation of the left lung. This is line or conventional tomogram, tomogram, hyperventilation of the left lung, of the left lung. On the rentgenogram of the organ of the thorax, you can see decreased transparency of the proper part of lung and intensification of the lung pattern, related to expansion of vessels or is observed stagnant hyperemia. And at this stage there is Holknecht Jacobson symptoms. Which is rapid deep breathing in mediastinum is displaced toward staggered and at forced breathing out toward healthy lung. These symptoms is determined by the method investigation in rentgenoscopy. Rentgenoscopy. You see, for hyperventilation on the rentgenogram of the organ of the chest, you can see decreased volume of the affected lung. This is decreased volume of the left lung. Decreased volume of the left lung. Decreased transparency. You can see more higher radiological density of the left lung. Position organ mediastinum. You can see displaced organ mediastinum to the affected site. You see trachea shift to the affected site. Is very good reveals online tomogram. You see trachea. Is normal trachea, localization, symmetrical process of spinosus of the spinal column. This is trachea shift to the affected site. You can see higher radiological density. In the results, affected lung contain lower volume gas, lower volume gas. Dome diaphragm shift more upper. Course of rib more oblique, intercostal spaces is narrowed. Therefore, you can see decreased volume affected lung. But gas present inside affected lung present, but volume gas is decreased. Of the healthy side, you can see symptoms hyperventilation. But if your production rentgenogram when patient do full inspiration, affected lung constantly volume decreased. These symptoms hyperventilation. These symptoms is named hyperventilation. Hyperventilation. Now I am show to you. Computer tomography axial projection lung tissue window. This is endobronchial cancer of the right main bronchus. You see. And the bronchial cancer of the right main bronchus, partial obstruction of the bronchus, Lumina bronchus decreased, but pathway is present. Hyperventilation, stage hyperventilation of the right lung. Now I am show to you. Now I am show to you hyperventilation upper lobe of the right lung. Hyperventilation upper lobe of the right lung. This is pictures you remember forever. Why? Before I am explaining to you Krupa's pneumonia. Krupa's pneumonia. And I am explaining to you Krupa's pneumonia. There are four stages contain Krupa's pneumonia. First stage, hyperemia. This is imagine necessary do hyperventilation upper lobe of the right lung. Necessary do differential diagnosis between first stage Krupa's pneumonia. Krupa's pneumonia. This is also present increased lung pattern, more high radiological density, upper lobe of the right lung. But I am explaining before, if present Krupa's pneumonia, volume of lobe, affected lobe, no change. Volume of damaged lobe is no changes, is normal. If hyperventilation present volume symptom, present symptoms, decreased volume, affected lung, decreased volume, affected lobe. You see, you see. On the rengenogram of the chest, you can see next symptoms. Decreased in the volume of the upper lobe of the right lung. Decreased volume, upper lobe of the right lung. Lower body is displaced to the upper. You see yellow arrow show. Is normal. Lower margin of the upper lobe of the right lung, what this is placed. Projection, normal projection, fissure horizontal. This is cross, rib number 4. You see, 1, 2, 3. Rib number 4, fragment anterior, margin inferior, and cross linea axillaris anterior, you see. Вот this is normal body, lower margin. As this is lower margin, shift upper. Shift upper. In results, decrease volume of the upper lobe of the right lung. And next symptoms, organ mediastinum, shift to the affected side, to the right side. You see, вот this is lumina trachea, shift to the right side, red arrow show, you see, lumina trachea. And also you can see radiological symptoms reduced the transparency of the upper lobe. Conclusion. Hyperventilation of the upper lobe of the right lung. Bronchoscopy with biopsy is recommended. Next. In third phase of cancer tumor, rentgenologically, this is second phase. Almost fully blocks bronchus. the third phase of cancer tumor almost fully blocks bronchus, but continues to remain invisible on an ordinary X-ray film. However, in this phase, consequences of violation of bronchial passage as valvular emphysema are well visible. You see, graphic image, valvular emphysema. Those in the phase of breathing in air is yet able to get through narrow space between a tumor and wall of bronchus. During breathing out, bronchus in the place of localization of cancer tumor sharply narrows and accumulation of remaining air in the distal departments of lung, maybe low, maybe segment, dependent of diameter bronchus which damage, and its progressive swelling takes place. Valve emphysema. Now, before I am explaining to you, when patients do inspiration, elastic bronchus have elastic property, and when patient do inspiration, wall of the bronchus enlargement and gas pass inside lumina of affected lung. But when patients do full inspiration, lumina wall of the bronchus is decreased, and occlusion lumina of bronchus. And gas which localization inside damaged lung, no passes outside, no passes in environment. When patients do full expiration, affected lung constantly volume, increased constantly, volume affected lung constantly increased. Rhinological symptoms are following. Increased transparency of lung on the side of defect. Next, the dome of diaphragm observed below ordinary. You see, affected side, dome diaphragm, this is right side, position dome diaphragm more down. And you see, I am showing to you minus excursion dome diaphragm, different between inspiration and expiration, absent, different absent. The organ of mediastinum are displaced into in the healthy side. You see, organ mediastinum shift to the healthy side. Intercostal spaces are extended. More horizontal position rib in affected side. Fourth phase of growth of tumors. Fourth phase of growth tumors is characterized by complete obturation of bronchus and development of atelectasis. That is collapse of lungs. Atelectasis can develop and a few hours after the complete covering of lumina of bronchus with cancer node. Main radiological pictures which character for atelectasis. Which character for atelectasis? On the affected side, you can see intensive, you can see intensive homogeneous shadow. Intensive homogeneous shadow. The damage lung, maybe low, maybe segment, is decreased in a volume. Collapse lungs, volume is decreased. Volume is decreased. Affected lung, volume is decreased. The organs of mediastinum are displaced in the affected side. Organ mediastinum shift to the affected side. The dome diaphragm absorbed higher than ordinary of the affected side. You can see on the rengenogram, you can see narrowing in the intercostal spaces. And more oblique position of rib, back posterior, more oblique position rib. Therefore, next, on the rengenogram, you can see if total atelectasis, you can see total shadow, shadow intensive homogeneity, and organ mediastinum shift to the affected side. You see lumina trachea shift to the affected side. On the healthy side, left side, you can see only margin of the spinal column. Arc, aorta descending. Arc, left ventricle is absent, Of the healthy lung, you can see symptoms, compensatory emphysema in results hyperventilation. Compensatory emphysema in results hyperventilation, in results hypoxia. On the right side, of the left side, of the healthy side, you can see symptoms increase volume of the healthy lung. Position dome diaphragm more down, course of rib back posterior more horizontal, position more horizontal, intercostal spaces more wider. Transparency of the healthy lung is increased. You see, now I am showing to you original imaging total atelectasis of the left lung. Total atelectasis of the left lung. The rengenogram of the chest organs in the PA projection, of the left, there is total shadow. You can see on the left side total shadow, Shadow is intensive, homogeneous. Organ mediastinum are displaced to the affected side, to the affected lung, to the affected side. On the right side, you can see symptoms, compensatory emphysema in results hyperventilation. Symptoms hyperventilation, symptoms increase volume of the right lung, I am explained to you before. You see, organ mediastinum shift to the affected side, arrow, red arrow show displacement to the left side, to the affected side. Next. Now I show to you, rentgenogram of the organ of the chest, and I show to you CT scan. I am showing to you CT scan. Axial projection of the chest. Soft tissue window. You see, on the rentgenogram, you can see on the left side, shadow is total shadow. Intensive shadow, homogeneous shadow. Organ mediastinum shift to the affected side. Of the right lung, you can see symptoms compensatory emphysema. Symptoms compensatory emphysema. On the computer tomogram, soft tissue window, which using contrast substance, using maybe ultravist, maybe VisiPak, demonstrated soft tissue mass. Soft tissue mass, which narrowed and obstructed of the left main bronchus. Left lung is atelectasis, and you can see symptoms pleural effusion. At bronchoscopy, a circumferential fibril obstruction at the bronchial lesions was found. Is very good reveals in lumina left main bronchus. Pathological formation, soft tissue mass. Now I am showing to you atelectasis upper lobe of the right lung. Atelectasis upper lobe of the right lung. You see, on the rentgenogram of the chest organs in posterior-anterior projection, posterior-anterior view of the right lung, you can see shadow localization, upper and middle fields, all zones, upper and middle fields, all zones. Shadow is widespread. Shadow intensive, homogeneous, shadow, intensive, homogeneous, low margin is distinct, low margin is distinct. But low margin shift more upper, shift more upper. Symptoms of decrease, present symptoms, decrease volume of the upper lobe, decreased upper lobe of the right lung. Lower body is displayed to the upper. The organ of mediastinum displaced to the affected side. To the affected side, to the right side. You see, red arrow show luminotrachea, luminotrachea, luminotrachea. You see, necessary do differential diagnosis between Krupa's pneumonia, upper lobe of the right lung, second and maybe third stage. Second, maybe third stage. And atelectasis upper lobe of the right lung. Before I am explaining to you, if Krupa's pneumonia upper lobe of the right lung, position organ mediastinum is normal. Volume lobe, no changes. No change. No change. If atelectasis, volume of the upper lobe of the right lung is decreased, and present symptoms decreased volume of the right lung organ mediastinum. Shift to the affected side, you see, luminotrachea. Luminotrachea. Shift to the right side. Lower margin upper lobe of the right lung. Shift more upper. Shift more upper. This is conventional tomography. Conventional tomography. Conventional tomography of the chest. You see, good reveals, good reveals. Shadow which localization of the upper lobe of the right lung. You see, luminotrachea, shift to affected side, lower margin of the upper lobe of the right lung, shift more upper, shift more upper. Now I am explaining to you atelectasis upper lobe of the right lung. Now I show to you bronchoscopy pictures. Bronchoscopy, bronchoscopy method investigation. Bronchoscopy, you can see tumor which obturation lumina of the bronchus. Obturation lumina of the bronchus. It's necessary to remember that violation of bronchial passage up to development of atelectasis is observed at the foreign body of bronchial tubes. Intrabronchial grooving benign formation is at pressure of on bronchus from outside. For example, by increasing lymphatic nodes. Therefore, for classification of diagnostic tomography or bronchography are applied. But bronchography and CT computer tomography are more informed. On computer tomography, malignant tumors were determined intrabronchial as soft tissue formation of a dissimilar structure, heterogeneous density from plus 25 Hounsfield unit to plus 75 Hounsfield unit. with uneven outlines and asymmetric narrowing of lumina of broadness. In some patients, the tumors spread to neighboring organs, large vessels, pericardium, esophagus, etc. Now I am show to you X-ray plane where present foreign body inside the bronchi. Inside bronchi. You see? This is I am show to you computer tomography in axial projection, foreign bodies present inside lumina bronchus, inside lumina bronchus. Property foreign bodies. This is maybe metallic foreign bodies, maybe fish bones, maybe plastic, maybe plastic. From on X-ray, from an X-ray point of view, they are divided into radiopaque, positive foreign body, X-ray positive foreign body. This is metal fishing bones. That is, they absorb ray, and this is foreign body give a shadow, give shadow. X-ray negative foreign bodies, this is plastic, this is maybe plastic. Next is very, very big topics. Cancer of lung, peripheral cancer of lungs. Peripheral cancer of lungs. Peripheral lung cancer develops from the epithelial tissue of a small bronchi located in the distal segments. Typical localization of peripheral cancer is the upper lobe, segment number one and number two, and the lower lobe, segment number six. However, the malignant process can be found anywhere. Peripheral lung cancer has the following form. Nodal form, cavity form, formation with contained cavity. The inner outlines of the cavity are by shaped uneven. The wall thickness is uneven. The external outlines of the formation are lumpy, uneven. Also, horizontal content level can be determined of the cavity. Apical cancer Pancoast tumors. Apical cancer Pancoast tumors is neoplasm, which localization is the upper lobe that occupies the area of the apex of the lung. As the tumor growth is destroyed of ribs and vertebrae. The malignant process spreads to the mediastinum, grows into the sympathetic trunk and branches of the cervical plexus. The clinical features of this form of cancer include pains of the shoulder, girdle, which pain in the shoulder girdle, which radiate spreads to arms, palm, edema, present corner triad, ptosis, miosis, and ophthalmos. There are many also by damage to the recurrent manifested by hoarseness of the voice. And phrenic nerve relaxation of the diaphragm. It should be noted that with this form of cancer, without an X-ray examination, patients are sometimes misdiagnosed. For example, arthrosis of the shoulder joint, osteochondrosis, etc. With the subsequent appointment of the wrong treatment. Corticopleural cancer. Corticopleural cancer originates from the subpleural regions of lungs, of the lung. The formation has a semi-oval shaped with a wide base adjacent to the chest wall. The tumor has a fuzzy, lumpy, radiant inner outlines from the side of the lung. Sometime coarse cord extend from the shadow of the lung to the lung. At it progress, the malignant progress spreads to the adjacent sclera, destroying the ribs and vertebrae. That is, cancer spreads mainly towards the chest wall. Pneumonia-like form, cancer of lungs. Peripheral lung cancer, classification, round or nodular tumor, pneumonia-like tumor, cancer of apex of lung, podcast tuberous cancer. Now I am show to you round-shaped cancer, for example, of the right lung. Peripheral lung cancer, you see localization. Peripheral lung cancer localization. Nodular lung cancer, nodular lung cancer. A round or knobby-shaped has the appearance of spherical or irregularly shaped knotty formation with clear outlines and a bumpy surface. A deepening of possible along the edge of tumors. Regular symptoms in the entry of a large vessels or bronchus into the tumor. Regular symptoms in the entry of large vessels or bronchus into the tumor. A evolution of peripheral, peripheral of cancer of lung. You see, stage number one, stage number one, main character, round tumoral node with precise outlines. Stage number two, you also, you can see peripheral shadow, peripheral tumor, peripheral shadow. But irregular form with tuberous indistinct outlines. Stage number 2B, present peripheral shadow and present enlargement root of the affected lung. And stage number 2, you can see peripheral shadow, you can see enlargement root of affected lung in result cancer, lymphadenitis, enlargement bronchopulmonary lymph nodes root of the affected site. And you can see drug symptoms. This is cancer etiology, lymphangitis. Cancer etiology, lymphangitis. When you can see these symptoms, peripheral shadow, drug symptoms, cancer lymphangitis, and cancer lymphadenitis, these symptoms is named symptoms bipolarity. Stage number three. Growth tumor, mainly peripheral side, and damage pleura, visceral pleura, and next damage parietal pleura. And on the rengenogram, you can see complication, you can see symptoms, cancer etiology, exudate pleurisy. Stage 3B, when growth cancer, mainly to the center, and you can see symptoms bipolarity, and present one more symptoms, you can see enlargement middle shadow, upper one by dot, upper part. In result, enlargement paratracheal lymph nodes. You see, now I am showing to you peripheral lung cancer first stage. You see, you can see shadow of the right lung, you can see shadow of the right lung. This is rengenogram of the organ of the chest. This is line tomogram of the right side of the right lung, line tomogram. On the rengenogram of the organ of the chest and PA projection of the right side, you can see shadow. Next necessary explain, localization. Middle fields and middle zones, side shadow, maybe middle focal, maybe gross focal shadow. Shadow have in diameter plus minus 1 centimeter. Shadow maybe minor intensive, maybe middle intensive. Homogeneity, outlines distinct. This is outlines indistinct, uneven. For first stage character, outlines distinct, round form shadow, outlines distinct, minor, maybe moderate intensive, homogeneity. Next step necessary do computer tomography investigation. Computer tomography investigation. If you can see on the rengenogram, this is formation, necessary do differential diagnosis between peripheral lung cancer first stage, tuberculosis, fibrous cavernous tuberculosis, maybe focal tuberculosis of the lung. Necessary do differential diagnosis between peripheral cancer and benign tumor, between peripheral cancer and cyst of lung, including echinococcal cyst, and so on. Eosinophil infiltrate of lungs. Now I am showing to you computer tomography investigation of the chest, of the left lung, of the right lung. You can see formation, which localization of the peripheral site. Which localization of the peripheral site. Of the left lung, you can see formation, which localization of the right lung. Stage. If you use a clinical classification, tumor, nodulous, metastasis, TNM, donor, tumor, this is size. Primary formation tumor nodes tumor nodulus. This is present or absent regional lymph nodes and metastasis. Present or absent metastatic damage. This is stage T1 tumors. This is stage T1B tumors. This is T1A tumors, T1B tumors. Next, peripheral lung cancer, second stage. Peripheral lung cancer, second stage. For second stage, peripheral lung cancer, character symptoms, bipolarity. You can see peripheral side, you can see of the right lung, you can see peripheral shadow, shadow moderate intensive, outlines indistinct, uneven. Next, you can see enlargement and non-structure root of lung, of the right lung, root of right lung, connection with middle shadow, root of the right lung, enlargement, non-structure, you don't can see head, body, tail. Next, you can see drug symptoms. Peripheral shadow, connection with root of lung. You see line shadow. This is line shadow, drug symptoms. This is cancer in etiology. Lymphangitis, cancer etiology, lymphangitis, enlargement root of lung, this is cancer etiology, lymphadenitis, cancer etiology, lymphadenitis. Cancer etiology, enlargement and inflammation, enlargement in results inflammation, in result inflammation, enlargement lymph nodes, root of the right lung. Cancer etiology, lymphadenitis. Symptoms bipolarity. Bipolarity, when you can see peripheral shadow, lymphangitis and lymphadenitis. Peripheral lung cancer, second stage. Symptoms bipolarity. Peripheral shadow, lymphangitis, and lymphadenitis of the right lung. Peripheral lung cancer of the left lung, second stage. This is rengenogram, symptom bipolarity. This is conventional tomogram, what reveals symptoms bipolarity. Peripheral shadow, primary tumors, cancer lymphangitis and cancer etiology lymphadenitis. Symptoms bipolarity. Computer tomography of the chest, axial projection. You can see primary mass with satellite nodules. You see satellite nodules in the lower lobe of the right lung. Lower lobe of the right lung. These symptoms, you can see symptoms bipolarity. In the third stage of peripheral lung cancer, third stage, further growth of tumor formation occurs mainly toward. Number one, I explained to you before, lymph nodes of the root of the lung and damage protracheal lymph nodes. And number two, you can see peripheral shadow and growth to the peripheral side and damage visceral and parietal pleura and present symptoms exudate pleurisy, cancer etiology exudate pleurisy. On the rengenogram, now I am explaining to you this is rengenogram number one. On the rengenogram, you can see shadow with symptoms which accompany symptom bipolarity of the right lung. And you can see enlargement, middle shadow and upper 1/2 part. Enlargement middle shadow in upper 1/2 part. You see? Enlargement middle shadow. In results, enlargement paratracheal lymph nodes. This is growth cancer mainly to the center. This is rengenogram number two, growth mainly to the peripheral side. On the rengenogram, you can see peripheral shadow and present symptom bipolarity, peripheral shadow, track symptoms, enlargement of structure, root of the right lung. But present one more symptoms on the right side, you can see symptoms, cancer etiology, exudate pleurisy. Upper margin, you can see shadow on the lower fields of the right side. And upper margin is oblique and indistinct, uneven. Linea Ellis-a, Dumas-o, character for exudate pleurisy, cancer etiology. Now I show to you axial positron emission tomogram and computer tomogram image of chest show of primary mass of the left lung. Excuse me, what this arrow show primary mass of the left lung. And also you can see of the right lower paratracheal lymph nodes. Paratracheal lymph nodes enlargement. Paratracheal lymph nodes. Both of which demonstrate intensive radiotracer uptake. Metastatic involvement of the lymph nodes was confirmed of confirmed at mediastinoscopic resection. For positron emission computed tomography, you're using radionuclide 18-phtor deoxyglucose. 18-phtor deoxyglucose including in malignant tumor. This is primary tumor, this is secondary tumor, this is damage paratracheal lymph nodes. Chest CT scan obtained of lung apex of different patients shows enlargement bilateral supraclavicular lymph nodes. Supraclavicular lymph nodes. Now I am showing to you. Now I am showing to you computer tomography, axial projection, soft tissue window. Reveals of the right upper lobe mass arrow show with mediastinal and carinal invasion, ipsilaterally located pleural effusion, you see pleural effusion, and thickening and enhancement of the pleura of the right side. Peripheral lung cancer, pancreas cancer, peripheral lung cancer, pancreas cancer. Cancer of the apex of lung is named pancreas cancer. Developed in the apical part of the lung and is able to grow into first and second pair of ribs, as well as into the processes of the cervical vertebrae. You see lesions of the apex of the lung and soft tissue. Guys, an apex cancer of peripheral cancer. No, before I am explaining to you, this is pancreas tuberous syndrome, developing in the area of apex. He has a tendency of the germination and surrounding tissue, nervous vascular interlacement pleura in the back segment of first rib. Of first three ribs, and even vertebrae where the destructive changes are determined. It's a neglected cancer of lungs. Now, on the rentgenogram of the PA projection of the right lung of the upper lobe, in first, second segment, reveals shadow, and outlines indistinct, uneven, shadow intensive, not homogeneous, and you can see uneven outlines and destruction of ribs, number one, pad posterior, and number two, pad posterior. Apical cancer of the right lung and corticopleural cancer of the left lung with destructive change in the ribs. Schematic image of the X-ray picture. This is pancosta, pancostal cancer, pancosta tobias cancer, apex cancer of the right lung, and left side corticopleural cancer, which destroy back posterior of ribs. Schematic image. Guys, today lecture is finished. Everybody student, I meet you in practical class in hospital Семашко. Goodbye, bye, healthy.